It is important to screen for CKD at diabetes diagnosis because early CKD detection and treatment decrease the development of kidney failure by up to 30 to 70%. Improved outcomes are seen when we screen, diagnose, monitor, and treat CKD complications and have early preparation for kidney replacement therapy, such as transplantation or dialysis. The urine albumin screening and monitoring card was designed to help busy providers understand this sometimes confusing topic. Click on the link above to download or print a PDF of this card. Let me give you a brief overview of the card. Albuminuria describes a condition in which a patient's urine contains an abnormal amount of albumin. High levels and/or a rapid rise in urine albumin may be a sign of serious kidney disease. There are two tests which are the gold standard for testing for kidney disease in people with diabetes. One is the urine albumin to creatinine ratio, or UACR. The other is the serum creatinine level with the calculated estimated glomerular filtration rate, or eGFR. Screen for albuminuria by checking a UACR at diabetes diagnosis and yearly thereafter. A diagnosis of albuminuria is made when the UACR result is at least 30 milligrams per gram on two separate occasions. Once diagnosed, monitor CKD by checking the UACR and eGFR at least once a year. Check them more often if they are rising rapidly, after implementing interventions, and in the later stages of CKD. Remember, you should not screen for albuminuria under certain conditions, such as if the patient has a UTI, or if the UA is positive for leukocytes, nitrite, or RBCs. Resolve these issues first, then screen for urine albumin. Not all CKD in patients with diabetes is due only to their diabetes. This is one suggested workup you can do to help rule out non-diabetes causes of CKD. Several strategies should be implemented to reduce albuminuria, prevent or slow nephropathy progression, and lower the risk of heart disease. These include controlling blood glucose, blood pressure, and lipids. The right-hand side of the card lists some of the tests still being used to evaluate urine protein and compares them to the test we all should be using, the UACR.